I mean, these isolators are not a shelf product. I mean, you cannot go to the producer and say, oh, I have a five-story building, please give me this much of isolators and this size of isolators. You cannot say that. I mean, they are tailor-made, specific to your building. And each of the isolators shall be tested. There are two types of tests in the course. One of them is qualification test, which is also called factory production test. The other one is the prototype test. The main aim of the tests are to verify the design properties that you used in your design. If they qualify, if these design properties you assumed in your design are correct or not. The factory production test, in some codes, it is required that 100% of the isolators, all of the isolators that you will use in your building should go on the factory production test. This can be done, the factory production test can be done in slow speed. The codes mostly allow this. And can be done in the, if there is a facility in the manufacturer's factory, inside the, by the manufacturer itself. And the loads and the displacements for this test are lower than the prototype test. However, the prototype test should be performed on independent laboratories and in very harsh conditions, the maximum displacements, maximum axial loads, these tests are performed in prototype tests. And the tested prototype units are not used in the structure, but the factory the units that are factory production tested, they, you can use these products in your building. Of course, if it satisfies your design criteria. There are several testing facilities all around the world, but mostly concentrated in Italy and United States. These are the testing facilities that I collected some information, but there might be some additional ones in the near future. Maybe these ones, this information was 2-3 years old. It might have changed. The largest isolator testing facility, independent testing facility, is at University of California, San Diego, SRMD testing facility. It can test isolators with a vertical load of 53,000 kilonewtons. And it's a 6 degree of freedom testing facility. I mean, you can give a real earthquake record to this testing facility and they can test your isolators with this record. The velocity is enormous. I mean, it's 1.8 meters per second. And the displacement capacity is nearly 600 millimeters. The second most commonly used testing facility is in Italy, in Pavia, EU Center. The vertical force capacity is 50,000 kilonewtons. Displacement capacity is nearly 500 millimeters. And the velocity is 2.2 meters per second. But the displacement capacity of SRMD, the one in California, is much larger than the AU Center. The displacement capacity is 1.2 meters in SRMD, while at AU Center it is only 500 millimeters. There is another lab in, again in Italy, Messina. I haven't been there, Eurolab. There is one in Potenza, I have been in Sisma lab, another one in Taranto, SysLab, and in Taranto Sisma lab. There is one independent facility in Turkey, in Eskişehir, which has a vertical load carrying capacity of acting force capacity of 20,000 kilonewtons, and with a velocity of 1 meter per second, and with a displacement capacity of 600 millimeters. Quite good. And the other ones, for example, another invented one is Ankry in Taiwan, and one in Canada, and there are some manufacturer laboratories in China. Hirun's laboratory, it's a very high capacity laboratory, and EPS's facility in San Francisco. And as far as I know right now, again, FIP in Italy as a testing facility, dynamic testing facility in Italy.